And we have to talk about anti-Semitism. It's reared its ugly head yet again in this country. Singer-songwriter Deborah Conway was performing with her husband Willie Ziggier in Hobart's Playhouse Theatre on Saturday night when pro-Palestinian protesters repeatedly interrupted the show. Conway is a Jewish Australian and has been targeted previously in the arts world. This is anti-Semitism, pure and simple. The protesters point to comments she's made critical of Hamas, pointing out that they put guns in the hands of teenagers. But what person would not be critical of the monsters of Hamas, who are an extremist Islamist terrorist group? No, let's be honest here. Let's be forthright. Conway is targeted because she is Jewish. This is anti-Semitism. This is bigotry and hatred tearing Australia apart.
You are complicit if you are silent.
Yeah, a few people in the crowd got it right, didn't they? Ignorant people triggering hatred. This latest example of anti-Semitism comes as Liberal MP Julian Lisa pushes in Parliament for a judicial inquiry into anti-Semitism on our university campuses. I spoke with him earlier and asked him what Jewish students and staff are experiencing now at our universities.
Chris, I think it's becoming increasingly difficult for Jewish students and Jewish staff on campus. I mean, you've seen these encampments, you've seen people in lectures and tutorials, having those lectures and tutorials invaded by protests, where people are saying hostile things about Jews and hostile things about Israel. You're having people invite people to protest and then asking people to put their hands up if they oppose Israel, and then taking photographs of people. I think the saddest story for me of all that I've heard is the story of a Jewish girl at a college, a residential college, and she wanted to put on a Shabbat dinner for her friends in the college, both Jewish and non-Jewish. And she hosted a lovely dinner. Anyhow, the next morning, people decided to put Palestinian flags under her door as a way of intimidating her. This is daily life now for Jewish students on university campuses. It's the same for Jewish staff who are finding themselves intimidated. And in some places where those protests have got so noisy, like in Sydney University, just simply unable to teach. You know, the purpose of a university is to educate people. The purpose of a university is to allow people to research and to teach. And that's all being interrupted by these protesters and the failure of university leaders like vice chancellors and the chancellors of the universities, frankly, to speak up and to take action to put a stop to this anti-Semitism we're seeing.
We are seeing a rise of anti-Semitism right around the country. We're seeing it in different ways. Actions on our streets, horrible graffiti daubing at schools. We've had an incident come to light just today where the artist, the singer-songwriter Deborah Conway, has had her performance interrupted basically because she is Jewish. So why is it so important for you to have a judicial inquiry into anti-Semitism on universities? Why should universities be the focus?
This is because universities are ground zero for anti-Semitism in Australia today, and because it's where universities, because people go to universities to learn about the world around them, and if what they are learning is that Jews don't count, if what they are learning is that Jews should be destroyed when you hear slogans like Intifada and River to the Sea, if what they're learning is that authorities are happy to sit idly by while Jewish people are intimidated and harassed as they try to go about their work teaching, learning and researching, and then that is a terrible thing that we are creating for the next generation of Australians. We will be missing out on the contribution of Jewish Australians, and we're creating an atmosphere where our country is no longer welcoming to all people, but only welcoming to some people. And that's never been the story of this country. The story of this country has been a country that has been welcoming to all people, but particularly to Jewish Australians who've been here since the days of the First Fleet and who flourished in this country like almost no other, because this has been a welcoming country where there's never been any official discrimination. We've got to draw a line in the sand, Chris, and say enough is enough. And that's what this judicial inquiry is about. It's an opportunity to bring vice chancellors to account, to bring chancellors to account, to have them cross-examined by silks in the witness box, and to ensure we provide an environment where Jewish staff and Jewish students can give evidence free of potential reprisals. That's why this is so important today.
Well, it's a very serious, heavy-handed, if you like, form of inquiry, the sort of inquiry that usually costs a bit of money as well. But as you say, you think it will draw a line in the sand when it comes to anti-Semitism. Now, you're putting it up through a private members' bill. Private members' bills typically just disappear into the sand. Do you have any sense that there'll be support for this? Are you getting any support from the government side, the Labor side, that they might support you in this and get this inquiry underway?
Well, when we last sat, Peter Dutton and Sarah Henderson, together with several crossbenchers in both Houses of Parliament, wrote to the Prime Minister calling for a judicial inquiry into anti-Semitism on campus. I've been talking about this since November last year, and I flagged at the beginning of May that I would be preparing this private members' bill. The government is yet to respond to that letter. What the government has done instead is set up an inquiry under the Human Rights Commission. That inquiry will deal not only with anti-Semitism, but with Islamophobia and racism on campus. Now, I have to say, if Islamophobia and racism are a problem on campus, that's a very bad thing. But we're seeing a pattern here where the government continually fails to acknowledge the particularity of anti-Semitism and the particular problem that's being faced by this. The second problem with the government's approach is the Human Rights Commission is just about the worst body that you could have to inquire into anti-Semitism on campus. This is a body whose job it is to ensure that people are free of harassment. It's a body that administers the Racial Discrimination Act. And yet it said nothing about anti-Semitism and its growth in Australia since the 7th of October. It put out a release supporting the rights of protesters after the Opera House protests. And it has several of its staff and its contractors who've been engaged in the doxing of Jewish creatives and artists, and also who've expressed pro-Hamas and anti-Semitic statements. I don't know why the government could possibly want to send Jewish students and Jewish staff to an inquiry run by an organisation where systemic racism against Jews is the order of the day.
Yeah, the Human Rights Commission is an abomination. It ought to be abolished, but that's a debate for another time. Thanks so much for joining us, Julian. I appreciate it.
Thanks, Chris.